In this particular segment, we're going to look at a parabolic partial differential equation. We're going to look at the explicit method, and we're going to learn it through an example. So the example which we are taking is the traditional equation for finding the temperature in a particular rod. We want to find out what the internal temperature of the metal rod would be when we subject this particular rod to two different temperatures on the two ends. And the differential equation which governs the temperature in the rod is a function of location. So that would be the location along the length of the rod, and time is given by this particular second order linear parabolic partial differential equation. So we are using the explicit method, which basically is the method where we are able to find the temperatures at different nodes based on the temperatures from the previous time. So the problem statement says that we have a steel rod right here. The temperature is subjected on the left side is 100 degrees Celsius. The right side is subjected to 25 degrees Celsius. The initial temperature of the rod is 20 degrees Celsius. And what we want to do is we want to find out what the temperature of the rod will be from 0 to 9 seconds. At 0, we already know what the temperature is. It is 100 degrees Celsius at this node. It is 25 degrees Celsius at this node. And the initial temperature of the rest of the nodes is 20 degrees Celsius. We are taking this rod, which is 0.05 meters in length, and we are assuming we are using a delta x. That is the node length, or the length between the two nodes, to be 0.01 meters, which basically implies that we'll have five segments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 segments, but we'll have a total of six nodes, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we're taking a delta t of 3 seconds. So since we are trying to find out what the temperature is between 0 and 9 seconds, we'll be starting with 0, finding out what the temperature will be at 3 seconds, then use that information to find the temperature at 6 seconds, and then use that information to find the temperature at 9 seconds. Since alpha is k divided by rho c, that's the thermal diffusivity, we are given the values of k, rho, and c, which we need for the equation. So the lambda which we have, so this is the general explicit method formula where we know the temperatures at a previous time step, and knowing the temperatures of the nodes surrounding the node which we are interested in the node I, and knowing the temperatures at the previous time step at the node surrounding the node I, we should be able to find out what the temperature would be at the time ahead. And this lambda is simply given as this particular part, where delta t is the time step we're taking, delta x is the distance between the two different nodes, and alpha, as we said, is the thermal diffusivity. Again, alpha is k divided by rho c. So what we're going to do is we're going to solve this particular, we're going to use this discretized form of the second order parabolic partial differential equation to find our temperatures at the nodes at the times ahead. So we are going to start with t equal to 0 seconds, so that corresponds to j equal to 0. That's the time node, is j is equal to 0. We know the temperature at the left end is 100 degrees and on the right it is 25 degrees, and we have four interior nodes and the temperature is, the initial temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. We find lambda. Alpha is given as, this is your k divided by rho c. That's k, that's rho, that's c. And that's your delta t, and that's your delta x whole square, and that gives us a lambda value of 0.4239. So our discretization equation for solving the second order linear parabolic partial differential equation looks like this. So give me the temperature at the time now, and I can give you the temperature at the time ahead. Give me the temperature at the node which I'm interested in and the two surrounding nodes, and I'll give you the temperature at the node currently. So if we want to find the temperatures at j equal to 1, t equal to 3, we are going to say that this temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, this temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. We want to find out temperatures, what happens at the interior nodes. So let's go and see how we're going to do that. So we already know the temperature at this node is 100 degrees Celsius, so we don't need to find that. Let's go and look at the temperature at node 1. So the temperature at node 1 at time 1 will be given as the temperature at node 1 at time node 0. So that's the 0 which we're talking about, plus lambda. And then these are the temperatures at the two surrounding nodes, which will be this node and this node right here. Those are the two surrounding nodes, and that's the node which we are interested in. So the temperature at the node T1, 0, which is this one right here, is 20 degrees Celsius, because that's the initial temperature. Lambda is 0.4239. Temperature at node 2, 0, that is this one right here, is 20. And then we have the temperature at the node which we're interested in is also 20. And the temperature at node 0 is 100 degrees Celsius, and that's what we are putting in here. So once we do the calculations, we get this as the temperature of node 1. So the temperature of this node here is 53.912 degrees Celsius. Similarly, we can find the temperature of node 2. So if we want to find the temperature of node 2, which is right this one, node 2 here, we are going to do the same thing. We're going to look at the nodes which are surrounding that particular node, and then we're going to look at the temperatures which are at the current time. So this is the temperature at the current time at the node which we're interested in. This is the temperature at the node to the right, node to the left, and by doing that we get our temperature at node 2. So we can use this particular thing. Similarly, we can find it at I equal to 3 and I equal to 4. We are not showing those calculations, but you can very well see how those calculations can be done. So if we do those calculations, we find out that the temperature at node, the left node and the right node are as given right here. And then we are finding the temperature at the node which is to the first one. And this is the second one, the third one, and the fourth one. And these are the temperature nodes which we have found out right here. So we got this, we got this, we got this, and we got this. What you're finding out, the temperature of these two nodes is not changing, and that's because of the nature of the explicit method formula, and has nothing to do with the temperatures there are 20 degrees Celsius. So that's a drawback of the explicit method, that the temperatures of the nodes which are not next to the external nodes do not change in the first step. So now what we want to do is we want to look at J equal to 2, which will correspond to T equal to 6 seconds. So we now know what the temperatures are at the external nodes. We also know the temperatures at T equal to 3 seconds. So we know the temperatures at T equal to 3 seconds. And we are going to find out what the temperatures at T equal to 6 seconds. So we follow the same procedure right here. We already know the temperature of this node is 100 degrees Celsius. Let's go and find the temperature of this node. So the temperature of this node will be based on the temperature of this node, and this node at the previous time. So that's what's going on here. And then we substitute the temperature. So this is the temperature at time t equal to 3 seconds of node 1. This is the temperature of node 2 at 3 seconds. This is the temperature of node 1 at 3 seconds. This is the temperature of node 0 at 3 seconds. And that's 100 degrees Celsius, because that's the boundary condition given there. That gives us the temperature of this node right here to be 59.073 Celsius. So similarly, we can find out what the temperature here is, what the temperature here is, and what the temperature here is. And let's go and see what those temperatures turn out to be. And this is what we find out. These are the boundary condition temperatures, so those don't change because those are kept as a constant. And this is the temperature which we just calculated. And similarly, you can find out the other temperatures at the interior nodes by writing down the equation in terms of the surrounding nodes as given by the general discretized formula. And now you're finding out the temperatures of the internal nodes. All the internal nodes are changing because the influence of, so in the previous case, we didn't have any change taking place in these two nodes. But since this changed and this changed, we'll find out the change is taking place on this node and this node. Had we had more nodes, there'll be some nodes which still will have 20 degrees Celsius as the temperature. Now, the last step which you're going to conduct is to find the values of the temperature at j equal to 3 for the time node, and that implies t equal to 9 seconds. So we know what the temperatures are at the 6 seconds. We've got to find out what the temperature will be at 9 seconds. Again, we're going to do the same thing. Let's suppose if I want to find the temperature here, that will involve knowing the temperature here and the temperature here and the temperature here at the previous time step, and that's what this is. We are finding the temperature at the time step, time node 3, which means 9 seconds, and this is the temperature at that node 1 at the second time step, temperature node 2 at the second time step, temperature node 1 at the second time step, temperature node 0 at the second time step. We substitute those values and we get this as the temperature at node 1 at time step 3. This is the temperature at node 2 at time step 3. So similarly, we can find out what the temperature at node 3 is and the temperature at node 4 is. Summarizing those, we get the values of the temperatures at different nodes. These are the boundary conditions. We are keeping the temperatures at the external boundaries to be a constant, so they will be the same throughout, but the temperatures at the internal nodes are now being found by using the explicit method. So what we're doing here is to better visualize the temperature variation along the location here. We are showing the temperatures. This is the temperature at node 0, this is the temperature at node 5, and these are the external temperatures, and they're staying constant because we're keeping them constant. So this one is 25 degrees Celsius and this one is 100 degree centigrade. So this is 25 degrees centigrade and that's 100 degrees centigrade, and see how the temperatures are varying. So the temperatures are varying as a function of time as you go along this arrow. This one corresponds to 3 seconds, this one to 6 seconds, and this one to 9 seconds. And you can very well see that at infinity what's going to happen is that the temperature is going to be a linear line, because you can very well see that when you reach steady state, this is going to be 0. So you'll have the temperature only as a function of x, in that case it will be equal to 0, and the solution to this will be just t is equal to ax plus b. So it's simply a straight line with this as a slope and this is the intercept. How do we find a and b? We know the temperatures at the external nodes. We can use those to find out what a and b are. But the bottom line is to understand is that as time goes on by and reaches steady state, the temperature is going to be vary linearly from the left node to the right node. And that's the end of this segment.